Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala falah. Hayya ala falah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wassalatu, wassalamu, rasulallah, assalamu alaikum alaika, wasabika, umatika, ajma'in, ashadu an la ilaha illallahu, watuhu, la sharika lahu, ashadu anna Muhammad abduhu, wa rasuluhu. And that is, all the praise is due to Allah, the guardian, evolver, and the sustainer of all worlds of knowledge. We ask Allah to the prayers and the peace to be on Muhammad. May the prayers and peace be upon him. The righteous servants, all of them here in America and throughout the world. And I testify with my conscious mind that there's only one God, Allah, alone without any partners. And I testify that Muhammad is his slave servant. I greet you again in the beautiful Arabic language of Assalamu Alaikum. I want to just greet my masjid here that I love, the Ali Khan Masjid, and all of the beautiful followers, and the Imam Rauf Abdullah Muhammad. I appreciate him giving me the opportunity to address you. What I did when I was sick, you know, your masjid came to my aid, and believe me, I'll never forget that. If you ever need me to do dawah, you know that's what I do, a lot of dawah anyway. And at one time I thought it was a bad thing to be the dawah imam. So, because I got mad, I mean, I had an argument with an imam. Because I was, he was trying to make me his assistant. And he said, well, you're going to be the dawah imam. I said, I don't want to be no dawah imam. I want to be like all the rest of the imams. You know, the intellectual ones, you know, the ones that are supposed to know so much, right? So, you know, I think about that. And then, you know, all of my time with this community, I've really been doing the work of a dawah, so I've accepted that part, and inshallah, I'm still trying to do dawah to help our community, and our community is the community that, you know, that we relate to, you know, the one that we were, that we grew out of, the one that we evolved out of. You know, we evolved, or the one that we became visible in America. I was telling a person the other day that if it hadn't been for our leadership in America, that when they tore those towers down in New York, they might have murdered us. You know, but we engaged, the interfaith community for 30-some years, hands down. I mean, we met all the top people, all the top leaders in the Christians and the Judaism and Buddhism and all of the different religions, and they couldn't do nothing to us. You see what them judges did to Mr. Trump? They shut him down. We met a lot of judges. I ain't myself personally came in contact with some judges, which we have some in our community too. You know, so this is important. So we have a logic that Allah has blessed us to come into, and you know, I'm so glad, you know, that I'm with y'all. You know, I just want you to know that I'm with y'all, and I don't ever want to be with nobody else. I just feel so fulfilled as a human being. So, I brought as a token of my appreciation, I brought a cake that I had made up specially for this community, and I hope everybody get a piece of it. And it's a velvet, red velvet, and it's delicious, because I ate one about 3 weeks ago, and I said, boy, well, this would be nice for to bring over here. So, you know, I found out who was making them, and she made it specially for y'all. So, inshallah, before you leave, make sure you get a slice. Praise be to Allah. So, you know, I'm here to just give my little khutbah. I don't know how smooth I'm going to be, but I'm going to, you know, just try to teach on Allah, teach on the guidance that Allah gives. So it's not too much. I mean, one thing about Islam, it's an admonishment, you know, and the admonishments are, you can list them all and put them on probably one side of a page, basically what Allah is calling us to. You know, and a lot of times we be looking for the heaven knowledge coming out of certain words and different things that's down in the root, and you can't get it unless you dig deep. You know, I mean, that's true too. That's true. But the fundamental information that's being revealed to us from Allah, this the fundamental stuff that's in our environment for our mind's soul, for our soul's mind. Because see, our soul is already fulfilled. You don't have to do nothing to that. You know, Allah already fixed that in your original pattern, in your original nature. Muhammad had it. Abraham had it. We know Muhammad lived a whole life amongst humans and didn't make no mistakes. Didn't make no human mistakes. He didn't fall into a worship in idolatry, and breaking the rules that Islam have established for human beings. It was no Islam for him, and he lived a whole life amongst humans and didn't give in. And when Allah chose him to be the representative to receive the revelation, he said he was on the highest level of any human that ever lived on earth, even Adam. And that's true when you study, you know, when you study, you find out that Adam had to bow down to him also. And then Allah asked us to bow, all of us, to bow down to Adam in his original nature. Because Allah don't need us to bow down to him, you understand that. He didn't never ask us to bow down to him. When you study our religion, we bow down to Adam as a symbol, bow down to what he brings to the human. And Muhammad did it without even having revelation. So that's wonderful. That means that, for me, that means that my self-esteem is so strong for my belief in Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it's so powerful for me as a human being that I don't never have to give in to drugs or whatever influences that's in the nature that's out there, that Shaitan puts out there. I don't have to fall into that trap. See? You know, we can do good and be satisfied with our own self and feel encouraged to be philosophical and to be naturally a philosopher. And most of us think we that anyway, even though we don't even have knowledge about that. You know, the soul is tricky. if you don't educate the soul, it'll become a mystic. You know, the soul will float out in space and be satisfied with doing nothing but being happy with itself and don't get the knowledge and don't care if it don't get the knowledge. But when you study and dig deep, then you come into the knowledge that enhances you and establishes you. And the only way you can do it, the only way that you can really come into it, is social. You have to come into a social knowledge. You have to know about evolution. So Allah says, "Kuntum kairu umatun ukrijat lanas," that you was evolved or you became visible. But the strongest definition in that word, ukrijat, is visibility. Evolve is too general for us because we'll go back out like a mystic and don't never come back. You know, we won't come back to reality. So alhamdulillah, you know, we have that wonderful nature, and there's no reason for us not to be, you know, extended into, we here in Washington, D.C., this, we can get in the race. Allah said, get into the race for all that's good. You know, compete. I remember Ali Khan, man, that boy, he was something. He would compete with anybody. He'd compete with kings and it would make no difference. You know, he would engage them and get the benefit out of, that's why we love him so much. You know, because of his ability and his continuous nature of believing that he was special. You know, and I felt the same way. I mean, all of us feel like that, believe it or not. We just got to keep reminding ourselves. The Quran just keep reminding you that you know, you're special. You're not ordinary. You know, you're not the ordinary thing that's rolling around here, submitting to everything except God, Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know. So we you know, we need to evaluate ourselves the way Allah have evaluated us. And Allah said that we are fiasani taqween, that we are created in the excellent, the most best mode possible. There's nothing else created, not a dog, a monkey, a ghost, you know, no knowledge. There's no knowledge on earth that man don't have the ability to discover it, read it, evaluate it, and institute it. That we have that ability. That's us. That's what Adam can do. Allah gave that to us at birth. So we got something special. Praise be to Allah. I don't want to be here all night because, you know, so many things to do. So inshallah, let's close the first part out in a short dua. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة كنا عذاب النار. Oh Allah, give us good in this world as well as in the next world and save us from the fire. Ameen. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu Rasulullah, assalamu alaikum ali alika, wa sabika, umatika, ajma'in, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wadduhu la sharika lahu, ashadu anna Muhammad abduhu, wa rasuluhu. Praise be to Allah, amma ba'd. Allah is powerful. We ask Him to bless Muhammad and the followers of Muhammad, all of us here in America, the righteous, throughout the world, you know, all, especially believers, Muslims, and the goods. Praise be to Allah. I testify that there's only one God, Allah alone, and Muhammad is His slave servant. I greet you again. Assalamu alaikum. Praise be to Allah, brothers and sisters. You know, we Allah says to, vie or strive as in a race for all that's good. That's our obligation. You know, let's compete. I would say, let's compete with each other. We don't have to be afraid of each other. We have to engage each other, and sometimes, we just want to come to Islam for peace. I know a lot of people like that who just want to come for peace. They want no struggles. They don't want to they don't want to argue anything. They just want to come for peace and give zakat and go home. But sometimes, you have to do more. You have to get to know one another. You have to struggle with each other, and then you can grow. You can't grow. See, the one thing about the nature that Allah created us in, the only way it can grow, it has to engage. And it has to engage its environment. And Allah says, Ikra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaqa. Right? Read in the name of your God who creates. That's the first word. Read what? You got to read the creation. You got to read what's in your environment. Adam tried to do that. He didn't have enough knowledge. His soul didn't understand what was going on. He knew he was wrong when he was eating out that wrong tree, but he didn't, he was tricked. So he didn't have enough knowledge so he could control or master or to be the caliph over the environment. So he gave into it. But we don't know. We got better than that. Now all we have to do is get educated. Don't be dumb. Whatever your environment is, let's find out about it. Anything in this environment, we can study it. Any one of us, and become a scientist in that field of knowledge. Allah says in the Quran that every creature knows its mode of prayer. Like a bird, and a dog, and a donkey, and a horse. They have their environment that Allah put them in. And then we can study that environment with our rational minds and figure out the nature and what's making it do what it do. And that's the prayer. That's the prayer of that creature. And we know what our prayer is. Our prayer basically is the Quran. We know that. And what's in this book? That's the prayer of us Muslims. What's the most important thing in the prayer? It's the Quran. All the other rituals, secondary. But the knowledge of the Quran cannot change. And Allah said, let there be no change in that. So we know that. So we have an obligation to learn the language, to learn the knowledge, to study the knowledge, to study what Allah is trying to give us, to study, to read, and then we have an obligation to read, then we have an obligation to read what is given. What is it giving us? We have to read that. And then we have to read where it came from and understand it. That's the three times that Muhammad had to read it. He had to read it to understand it. So we don't want to just recite the Quran and don't know what it's talking about. So you got to get a dictionary. You got to look up the word ikrajat. And find out where it's coming from. And you got to look up these words that we take for granted all the time. That we hear and we think like evolved. We have to look that word up. In the Quran, in this original language. So we can learn what Allah is trying to tell us in a stronger sense. I don't know if I'm making sense. Maybe I'm just half crazy. Like, I could be all of that. I don't know. But inshallah, I believe in me. You have a problem with me. I don't know about somebody else, but I believe in me. And Allah has blessed me to be successful as a human being. So I feel good. I'm glad I know you people. And inshallah, I know I'm going to see you some more, God willing. And I'm glad I had an opportunity to come and just express a few words. Inshallah. I think I don't know about the announcements or anything like that, Brother Imam, but we're going to keep my salat, I guess. In announcements first.
You got good time.
I got good time? Well, see, I do all mine in 1 second. I don't need all that time. But praise be to Allah. I mean, when Allah tells us that we are banned of people, brought out. We are banned of people, brought out for the good of all people. And Allah tells us not to establish ourselves on the my roof. When you look up that word my roof, it's the same, sir. When you look up the word my roof means like Arafat. My roof. It's the same root word. Guess what? It means to get to know. So Allah says establish yourself on the my roof, not the munkar. Now when you look up the munkar, it means something that's hidden, something that's sleazy, something that's untrue. So why would you establish yourself on something that's not right? Something that's like falling off a cliff. It ain't gonna last. Allah says establish on the my roof, not on the munkar. Right? So that's what we have to do. Establish on what's already well known. Establish on our history that's well known for humankind. Family, love, kindness, compassion, all of these kinds of things. Don't establish on ignorance. Establish on knowledge that humans have already studied and preserved. Most of the good stuff, human beings preserve it. That's the nature of man. That's the nature that Allah put in us. So we ain't just talking about Muslims, we talking about man all the way back from the beginning. This is what the Quran is bringing us to. So don't establish on the munkar, establish on the ma'ruf. And forbidden, it says, forbidden that which is wrong. It's forbidden. Establishing what's right and forbidden what's wrong. Tadbir, that's the Quran. That's the language in the Quran that Allah brings us to every time we read it. So like I said, there's only like one side of a page of reminders, but it's so powerful for your development as a human being. And when you obey it, if you keep reading it, you're going to obey it. It's like anything else. It's like you start off, you don't know nothing, you're small, and you keep learning. Then you get knowledge, and you become brighter and smarter and more qualified to do whatever you have to do. The Quran is the same way. But if you don't read it, you don't get it. If you don't study it, you're not going to have it. It don't make no difference. But if you're reading it, and you're feeling it, your soul is feeling it, you can't help but responding to the knowledge that's in your environment. Now that's Islam. That's the Islam that we had when we first came in Islam, when we didn't have nothing from the Quran. It was hidden, but it was working on us. And we have to know that. Why? Because there were certain keys. Now that's too much. I don't want to start that because it'll make me feel not satisfied that I finished what I was trying to do. But inshallah, I think I'm on it. Now, my time is pretty good, so I got 5 more minutes. No. Praise be to Allah. Yeah. Well, I'm just, because I can't go nowhere. I'm slow now. I used to be too fast. Now I'm too slow. Praise be to Allah. So we have a community that we need to work on too. And the one thing that we have to realize, we got a lot of damage. We do. We have a lot of damage in our community. People who have been damaged from psychological stuff that the psychiatrist can't figure it out, But they know you got to bring it out and you got to deal with it. And this is what we have to do. You know, we have to deal with our sickness. I mean, nobody else is going to deal with it, but we have to deal with it. And believe it, if we act like psychiatrists, I got a bunch of children that was in the first, and I got a lot of experience dealing with damage. You know, and believe me, we got a lot of damage. And we need really Allah to help us with it. There's no way. I'm reading the works from the psychologists out there. They have no idea how to fix this stuff we got. Only us. And once we fix ourselves, the whole world will have to listen to us. And that's what we need to understand. That we got, you know, we got something to contend with. You know, who else on the earth believed that we planned our history 50,000 years in advance? I don't know nobody else that ever believed that. But I know I believed it. And so many other things, you know. This is what, and a lot of our people haven't forgave their own self for falling into that. They still spinning. They still got hate in them. And the hate, they putting the hate on us. They ain't putting it on nobody else. They putting it on us because they can't understand how we can now believe a new knowledge, you know, and we're not benefiting from it. Some of us are, some of us might not be, some of us, you know. But I'm saying that's the kind of damage we got in our community. And we got pioneers that's carrying that damage, you know. And we got people who would never even came in the temple that's carrying damage like that. And the young people need to understand that and how to deal with it, you know, and don't try to hide it. That's the problem. All these important people that's been around for a long time, they trying to hide that stuff. You know, so you can't hide it. You got to deal with it. You have to engage that. And then, once you engage it, then you'll have the knowledge will come to you of how to deal with it. But if you don't ever engage it and you don't ever keep striking it, you're not going to find the knowledge that's going to make you understand how to deal with it as a human being. Now, we can deal with it like this society deal with it. Just lock it up. You know, forget about it and feed them dog food. Don't give them no, they don't have no information to help the brain. I think that's enough. I keep going. I be done confessed. And I don't confess. Praise be to Allah. So I thank you. Keep my salat. Allahu Akbar.
You need a chair?
Yeah, I need a chair.
Okay. Go ahead and use that one.
Stout.
Ten of them?
Come on. Yeah. I just feel a little bit different. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله اكبر الله اكبر
الله
الله اكبر الله اكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر نفاثاته في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس مالك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
تكبير
الله أكبر
تكبير
الله أكبر
تكبير
الله أكبر
Dear believers, we want to thank Imam Bilal Omar of Baltimore, one of our pioneers, one of our sheikhs, for coming down to give the khutbah. They're having a new Africa affair next weekend. It includes a banquet, includes some other festivities. It'll begin there with Juma Friday on the, I believe it's the 14th, perhaps the 14th, and then it'll go through that Sunday, which I believe is the 16th. And they will have affairs. I think we have a poster and we have some tickets. Imam Bilal Omar is here. If you have any questions, please support the new Africa Islamic effort there in the city of Baltimore, one of the great cities where Al-Islam was kept alive back in the early 40s and 50s and 60s and 70s, before Islam became popular in America, when people were afraid to declare themselves as Muslim. This community was doing that. We also have tomorrow, we have the martial arts program from 10 to noon. We have the Brothers Halakha, which from 10 to noon. We will be announcing periodic fish fries that we'll be having in this this area. On Sunday, we have the Arabic class, and we have the Talim. Please support those efforts. And we also are asking that you please contribute to the sadaqah and the zakah that we need in order to expand this place. And we still have a building drive, as you can see. We are raising funds because we would like to purchase some land so we can build out the Ali Khan Islamic Center that we have envisioned. Sister Ophelia, is there anything else that we need to cover?
As-salamu alaykum. I just want to make sure that we thank our believers, those who haven't been here for a while, those who are new, welcome. We're glad to see you. And today it felt like homecoming. You know, every time I looked up, I saw somebody new that I knew from years ago, but we're one big family wherever we go. And we just want to thank you again for coming. Don't forget to visit us. We have not only bean pies, we have the delicious looking cake that Brother Imam bought from Baltimore. That's free. But we also have cookies and we have other things. This is a means of fundraising, trying to help our masjid grow. And believe me, just that little bit every Friday helps tremendously. Also, the date that we were talking about in Baltimore is the 15th. We have a table of eight, I believe, and we have two tickets left. The others have been taken. So please try to join us. We went last year. It was fantastic. Food was good. The speaker was good. Imam Ronald Rashid is the key speaker. He was the one who did part of our Ramadan sessions last year. So please join us next Saturday in Baltimore. And there are other events coming up. We'll announce them as we get closer. We'll let you know when the fish fry and we have food giveaway and flea market coming up. So stay tuned. And the one big thing, keep July in mind, because July we want to take a trip to Louisville, Kentucky, to the Muhammad Ali Center. And we're going to have buses, not just from Masjid Ali Khan, or Ali Khan Islamic Center, but Masjid Muhammad, or anywhere, Baltimore, wherever you're from. We'll let the information will be coming soon, so look for it. Again, thank you so much for being here with us. As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum salam. Also, don't forget that the Nasim Conference and the 80th anniversary at Masjid Muhammad will be the weekend of the following weekend, around the 22nd of April, and that the Mid-Atlantic Imams will be meeting that weekend as well. So please support. And also know that we are planning a Ramadan session here for the believers, and we want to make sure that we reach out to Baltimore and everyone else so we can all come together. We want to give our salams to Brother Sheikh Doc and his wife Annette, and we see Sister Ruth, and all these believers. Now we have a couple more announcements. Do you have an announcement, Brother?
Yes,
come on in. Come on up here, please. Give us your name and give us your announcement.
My name is Shuja
Muhammad.
Can I have your attention, please?
Praise be Allah. My name is Shuja Muhammad, and I do dawah. Just came back from Atlanta, Georgia, and we had the opportunity to make a presentation there at the Capitol. We also was there in Chicago, and we did workshops in Louisiana, made presentation. And what we do, we ask the believer, you know, I'm American Muslim, so So our approach to Dawah might be a little bit different from the Middle Eastern brothers or brothers from other countries. You know, but what we is dealing with is the removal of all racial images that attempt to portray God. We know that's a big problem. That idea have been established in this society and is causing a great division. And we get plenty of help. We've been getting plenty of help from Caucasian, other nationalities. Our biggest problem, believe it or not, was African American. That's our biggest problem. You know, so we are asking you all for your help. I got some literature before you leave I can pass out to you. And if we can get together, you know, and deal with this problem, I really appreciate it. And I think it's going to help our future generation. So we thank you, Brother Imam, for this opportunity. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. And you all know that the CRADE, the Committee to Remove All Images of the Divine, was established by Imam W.D. Muhammad, brother Allah, may Allah be bless him and grant him the highest place in paradise. So this is something that is we believe in, and that we believe there are many Christians and Jews that support this concept that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's no respecter of a person. He's the Elah for all. So thank you, brother, and we will be working with you. Are there anything else, any other announcements before we close out? Again, thank everyone for coming out, and we pray that everything we've said that has been benefit. If anything that we have said that has not, we ask Allah's forgiveness. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.